It is opt or drop time. What if your child's body was stuck in fight or flight mode, triggering inflammation and immune imbalances and constant stress? We're exploring today Pectasol. Can this gentle product, Pectasol C, target a hidden driver of all that response and help bring the body back to balance? Let's find out. What is Pectasol C? Pectasol C is a form of modified citrus pectin, so it's derived from the pith, that white part, of citrus fruit. But it's not just any fiber, it's been altered in a very specific way, breaking it down into much smaller parts so that it's absorbable by your small intestine and can actually get into the bloodstream and do its job on a cellular level. Unmodified citrus pectin is too large to be absorbed by the gut, so it would just pass right out. But Pectasol is clinically proven to enter the circulation, and that's what makes Pectasol very unique. Hi, I'm Dr. Theresa Lyons. I'm a Yale University trained scientist and autism parent, and I teach parents like you the cutting edge science of autism so that you can make the best decisions for your child based on quality information. What does Pectasol actually do in the body? Okay, so Pectasol works by blocking a protein in the body called galactin 3. So you can think of galactin 3 like the boss of your body's emergency team. So when there's a real problem, it helps fix things. But sometimes this boss doesn't know when the emergency is over. I'm sure you know bosses like that who just keep escalating. So if it keeps sounding the alarm, it can make your body feel like it's always in danger. Therefore, you're staying in fight or flight mode, even when the danger, the inflammation, the infection is over. So what happens is then you have too much inflammation and too much stress. Pectasol helps calm things down by turning off that false alarm. There are over 90 published research publications involving Pectasol, so it actually has a wide variety of actions in the body, but that's the mechanism of action. So in the context of autism and neurodevelopmental issues, we're starting to learn how more and more inflammation and immune dysregulation play such a huge role, right? Everyone's familiar with the FRAT test and the autoantibodies in the brain that block the folate. This is all related to the immune system and inflammation. And that's where Pectasol comes in. So Pectasol, this modified citrus pectin fiber from the actual pith from the citrus fruit, it's been modified to be very small. And what it does is Pectasol can enter into the bloodstream through the small intestine and then bind directly to galactin 3, therefore neutralizing its harmful effects. So if you think back to that analogy of the boss and it's, you know, there's problems everywhere, right? Pectasol comes in and says, hey, calm down. Let's go meditate, right? And so it's basically neutralizing that harmful effects. So you can think of it as an off switch for one of the body's chronic disease pathways. And so when you shut that off, this leads to lower inflammation, less tissue fibrosis in organs like the brain, the heart, kidneys, and liver, and also improved immune imbalance. So you can take that and shift off from that fight or flight, that constant, I'm in stress, I'm under attack. You can shift your body more to being balanced so that the immune system can react when needed, but also shut off when not needed anymore. And a lot of times when this gets stuck, people start to get very sensitive to all different kinds of things. So this is an important aspect to understand. And you can also increase detoxification. That is exactly what we want for many of our kids. And so this isn't theoretical. There are over 90 published studies on Pectasol, including human clinical trials that demonstrate these effects. However, I want you to be aware that there is not one single study focusing specifically on autism. Let's get into detoxification a little bit. So Pectasol helps the body remove heavy metals like lead, mercury, arsenic, and cadmium. There's published research on that. And here's why it's so impressive and unique and why many doctors like this product. Pectasol can bind to these toxins without affecting essential minerals like calcium, magnesium, or zinc. So if you've ever worked with binders, I'm sure your doctor have said, okay, we gotta make sure we're adding minerals. Sometimes you add minerals on the weekends when you can kind of space things out because with school and schedule, it's too much. But the real benefit for Pectasol, or maybe one of the real benefits of Pectasol, is that it doesn't bind up all the beneficial minerals that are in our body. And so that's definitely important for kids with autism who might already be dealing with nutritional imbalances. You certainly don't want to give a product that would make that worse. So it's important to understand that Pectasol doesn't bind up essential minerals like other binders can. Pectasol also gently supports mold detox by binding to those toxins like mycotoxins, and it helps the body remove them through the urine. Pectasol also reduces inflammation triggered by mold exposure. This is when you start to get into mast cell activation. And so when the body is triggered and it is in so much of that fight or flight, everything gets sensitive. So Pectasol, by binding the galactin-3 and reducing that cascade of inflammation and immune modulation, it makes the body easier to heal without that overwhelm. Okay, let's get into that a little bit more. So immune system modulation. Pectasol doesn't just calm the immune system, it also helps it work better. So it's been shown to increase the activity of natural killer cells, which are like your body's frontline defenders, right? So when there's an infection, that's what's getting out there first. But also at the same time, it helps bring balance to overactive parts of the immune system, especially those driven by galactin 3. So many doctors, after you start healing for a while and you get some progress going, many doctors then will prescribe different drugs that help with immune system modulation. But with Pectasol C, you don't need a prescription. So this is a very gentle way, but effective way, and one that's accessible to parents. How is it taken? All right, I have a table full, if you could only see, I have a table full of products here. We have powdered forms, we have chewables, and we have capsules. So we'll start out with the capsules. I would say that's my least favorite. So this is the capsule. It's like your regular size capsule. The thing is, you need to take 6 of them for it to be like one serving, and I'll get into dose a little bit more, but for 5 grams you need 6 capsules. That gets to be a lot. If you're doing that every day, you can certainly kind of get into pill fatigue, which it happens. So there is capsule, but just keep in mind that you'd have to take quite a bit of them. We have powder, we have unflavored, and we have lime flavored, and then there's even berry flavored, and I don't have that one right here. The lime, I am surprised at how good it tastes. I thought lime, ew, that's gross. Who wants to drink lime? Hey, this is the unflavored. I know unflavored is important for kids who are, picky eating issues. So let's test out the unflavored and I'll kind of show you what it looks like. Just get it all opened up here. All right, so there's a little scoop. And so one scoop is one basically serving, one dose. So it's a pretty small scoop. Get it in some water. All right, and I found if you kind of just dump it all on top, all at once, you get these like globs. You can see them a little bit. I have my spoon. So we can stir it up. I find if you just sprinkle it more on top of the water rather than just dump it in, it avoids getting these clumps. But you can see, you know, that's kind of clumpy. So you just have to then stir a lot more. So if you just sprinkle on top, I found that is what works the best. Although I have to say, when it's the lime flavor, you get this burst of lime, and I don't know, it's kind of fun. It's like bubble tea, sort of. All right, so this is what it looks like. Obviously, it's going to change how a drink looks. I feel like there's like a taste, but not a taste. I think it's more a texture difference that is making me think it tastes different. Let me start again. There's not much of a taste difference, but I do feel like it changes the texture a little bit. So then you can kind of perceive it as tasting a little bit, but there's no taste. There's no taste. And there's no smell. Definitely. No taste, no smell. So that's the unflavored. The lime flavored, I really like. Here, I'll show you what I mean by sprinkling it on top. So I have another, and this is about 8 ounces of water. So let's see if I can show you what I mean by just, you just lightly sprinkle. Kind of like, you know, when you salt food and you just kind of spread it, and you just evenly a little bit around, a little bit at a time. And you can see how a lot of it is like floating at the top. That's what you want, because then you don't have as many clumps. So color wise, it's the same. So this is the lime and then this is the unflavored. It's color wise, it's pretty much the same, but I will tell you the lime tastes, I was very surprised. The lime tastes pretty good. Yeah, it's so, it's like good. I would drink that as a drink, which is weird because I'm not really like a fan of lime, but it's done really well. Now your child may not like lime, but taste wise, this is pretty good. Let's just keep going. There is a chewable. So I have not done the chewable. how many chewables do we need? 2 chewables for 2.4 grams. Oh yeah, okay. So I think I like the powder form the best because you put it in a drink and it's done. For the chewables, right, again, I know we like to have options for our kids. Let's get this all out. Okay, so they're pretty big. I wonder how they're gonna taste. All right, so you need 4 of these to equal 1 of those scoops of the powder. So that's kind of a lot of chewing. Let's see how it tastes. No. I got some of that cotton on top. Ugh. Okay, wait. Let me get a new one. That was gross. Okay. No cotton whatsoever. All right. Okay. Taste-wise, it's fine. It does have this nice tangerine flavor to it. It's not overpowering. It's not like gross for sure. There's no added sugar. So that's good. It's sweet without sugar, which is good. I could do one of those, but the thought of having to do 3 more is a little too much for me. I'm like, oh, really? Do I have to? It's not bad. It's just that that's a decent size amount and it's on the thick side. So if your child likes these kinds of chewable things, I think it would be a great option. I can see how that wouldn't work for some kids, for sure. But it's great. You have all these options. Okay, so let's just talk about how you take it in dosing and all that stuff. So those are the different formulations. It's best taken on an empty stomach, away from food and supplements. So that means either 30 minutes before food or 1.5 hours after. And a lot of times what parents do at school pickup, that's when you would give this. Because if your child probably hasn't eaten in 30 minutes or so, you give them this, whichever formulation you want. You drive home and boom, by the time you're home and you're ready to eat, it's been 30 minutes. So that's fine. Or, you know, your kid gets off the bus, you give it to them then, and he kind of puts it around and be like, okay, we gotta change and, you know, just settle in. And then before you know it, it's 30 minutes. If you're starting out, definitely the suggestion is to start low and slow. Watch for different signs of detox or reactions. There's usually not, because this is a very gentle approach, but you always want to be mindful, right? So you want to look for like mood swings or digestive changes, fatigue. It's important to stay hydrated, 100%. You've got to stay hydrated when you're taking, you know, binders and you're wanting to flush things out in the urine. You need urine to flush it out. So you've got to stay hydrated. Sometimes, I don't hear this often, but every once in a while there might be an issue with constipation. Typically when you take binders and there's an issue with constipation, it's more of the strong, harsh ones like charcoal or some of those other binders that are available, which are good and appropriate, but you just have to keep all this in mind. So constipation is typically not an issue, but again, you have to stay hydrated. Okay, so dose. So in teenagers, I've seen doctors recommend taking up to 20 grams a day. Now the research is showing lots of different active doses. A maintenance dose a lot of times for teenagers and adults are 5 grams. So that would be one scoop. And so if you're taking 20 grams a day, that's 4 scoops. And some of the clinical trials that have been published, they've been giving this twice a day, which when someone's in school, it's definitely a bit harder to just organize the schedule for taking something like this that needs to be away from food twice a day. So for smaller kids, a lot of times the dose is that 5 grams once a day, and you know, you work up to it. You can take this with other supplements. Many doctors usually say just take it on its own just to be safe, but you can, like with probiotics, you can take it with other things. Prescriptions are usually taken away, like at least an hour away from Pectasol before. And for kids who are very sensitive, Pectasol C can help calm those overreactive mast cells by lowering galactin 3. So sometimes I've seen doctors even just start with just a few sprinkles. So not even a quarter of a scoop, right? You really start low and you start with a very small amount and you work your way up that way. And when you reduce these mast cells, and you're reducing the triggers there, right, getting at the root cause, you've got to do both, then you can see symptoms like histamine intolerance, so different food sensitivities, brain fog, you might see changes of focus, and also skin reactions. And then as the kids can tolerate a higher dose, you increase those. And you also then see that they can tolerate much higher doses of different supplements and prescriptions. So again, once you're lowering that fight or flight, then the body can open up to a lot more. Confused by all the information about autism? There's a lot. My desk is just covered with stuff right now. I've got you. Click the link below to see how we can work together. Let me break down the science and provide you with clear, actionable steps to make your path forward much easier. All right, so to summarize, we have Pectasol. Pectasol is a clinically studied, highly absorbable galactin 3 blocker that may support inflammation reduction, immune system balance, gentle detox of heavy metals and mold, organ and tissue repair, amongst so many other things. It's safe, it's definitely well studied, without a doubt, and it's widely used in functional medicine. If you're building a personalized plan for your child or yourself, it certainly might be worth exploring. And that is why Pectasol C is definitely an opt without a doubt. It is definitely something good to have, and evaluate it if it makes sense for you.